Messick's, a helping hand with your land.
Hello, my name is Eddie, service technician here at Messick Farm Equipment. Today we're going to talk about servicing a C-232 CTL loader. First thing we're going to do is we're going to pull the track loader in, put the boom up, lock it out. From there, we're going to take and loosen up the back of the cab and tilt the cab. All you got to do is there's two bolts that stick up with nuts and a washer on either side. We're going to remove the nuts and washers, like so. From here, we'll go to the front of the cab. We'll grab hold of the handholds, tilt the cab front. Cab should come all the way up. The red knob down in the bottom should fall down and lock. That says our cab is locked in and can't fall down on us. From here, we'll go on to the inside, talk about some of the things that are underneath the cab. So here we are, cab's up, couple of key components underneath the cab. Your engine controller right here, this is a Tier 4B machine, final. So your engine controller, flasher relays, your start solenoid. Down here we have, this is a mechanical machine, so these are your drive pumps. These would be your linkage to your handles. As you move your handles forward and backward, this linkage moves, makes your machine go forward and backwards. Your main control valve would be down here. This is what makes your boom and bucket go up and down. The other big thing that they changed here recently is they put all of the electrical components down here underneath the cab. They're in these sealed areas here. Squeeze both ends, open those up. Above those, they have labeled on what each fuse controls and what size fuse should be in the hole. So now we're back here at the back of the machine. You'll want to open up your rear lid. On your rear lid, if you have a closed cab machine and it has air conditioning, this will be your condenser. You'll want to make sure that you keep this free from dirt contamination. Blow it out as needed. We'll open up the rear door. This will give us access to fuel filter, which is now located here on the door. There's also a fuel filter located up underneath here, right next to your air filter. As we come across, you got your hydraulic filter, hydraulic fill, and then your hydraulic sight glass. Now, right now, as you see, my sight glass is empty. With the boom being up in the air, it will drain out enough that it looks empty. As soon as we put the boom back down, that oil level will rise back up. The other thing to note is on all the new Tier 4s, whether it be a skid loader or a tractor, they've changed the coolant to what they call Oat Coolant. This coolant is not compatible with any of the old style coolants. So heed this, if you have Oat Coolant, you must use Oat Coolant to top off if you have a leak or anything else. Like on some of the other units, the coolant reservoir is off to the side. If you use a flashlight, you'll be able to shine down in and see what your level is. Also, if you look down over, you can see your belts. Check the condition of your belts. Make sure that they're tight. So to gain access to your oil filter and battery, it's behind this cover. You need to remove these four bolts. Now in bond here, gives you access to your battery, to your oil filter, and your drain hose is teched up underneath there. Now, if you need to jump start your unit, you don't have to take this off. All you need to do is open up your rear door and hook your jumper cables to the main positive of the battery and find a good solid chassis ground. From there, your battery will charge and you'll be able to jump start it. So when it comes to servicing your tracks, track tension is important. Inside here, under this cover, is a grease zerk. This is how you tighten your track. If you take this bolt out, loosen this one up, this will swing down. Inside there is a grease zerk. Applying grease to that tightens up your track tension. You should have the vehicle raised up off the ground, and then consult your operator's manual for the actual distance for how tight your track should be. Also, while you're servicing it, you'll want to at least check and or drain your planetaries. These two holes are how you do that. This is your drain hole. Put that at 6 o'clock. Fill hole will either be at 9 or 3. If you're just checking it, remove this plug. Oil should be right up even with the plug. If you're draining it, you can drain the oil out, put it back in, fill it back up till it's even with the plug. Okay. So with everything else being done to our skid loader, we got to put our cab back down. In order to do that, we have to lift the lock and put it on its utmost position so that it'll stay up, allowing us to push the cab back down. And all we got to do is push on the cab. It'll lower back into place. Hold it for a second so the shocks stay down. From there, we can grab our hardware and lock it back down. So with all new machinery, serial numbers is becoming an integral part of everything that we do. Serial numbers are now being used in the construction industry, farm equipment, to look up parts. Serial number plates on this unit and all units like it are back here. We are back on the right-hand side, right above the track. If you ever call into your parts department, service department, needing parts and or service, they will very well might ask you for this. This is very important. You can pull that number off of there, write it down in case the plate were to ever come up missing. Again, very important to keep a hold of that. Need that for all your parts and your service needs. Okay, so that's the basics of servicing a New Holland C232. Tilting the cab, location of all your filters, greasing it, checking your track tension. If you have any other questions, you can consult your owner's manual. Call us at 1-800-222-3373. Visit us online at messick.com. Thank you.